Hello everybody. In this part of the video series, I will show you how to use the eSankey Live Links in an advanced way. If you didn't watch part 1 yet, I highly recommend you to do so. We are ready to start. Do you still remember the company that wanted us to create the energy Sankey diagram of the previous video? Now that this diagram is finished, the company starts requesting new diagrams in the same format as the first one to use them in upcoming annual energy reports. That's exactly what we will achieve in this video. In part 1, we have filled the diagram with data by connecting the eSankey file to a single Microsoft Excel sheet. Each flow got a live link reference to an explicit Excel cell. The key to reuse our Sankey diagram countless times is to use advanced Excel functions. In the last video, I've been using the values of this fictitious dataset for the year 2017. Now we get another sheet of the same format for the year 2018, but there could be many more of them. I want to update my Sankey diagram by referring to the newest dataset, and this is where advanced Excel functions come in. Flexible references can be realized either with the H lookup, V lookup, or the indirect function, which is the one that I'm using in this video. If you're not familiar with the indirect function, I recommend to watch matching videos first. I'm using the indirect function in the following way. What I need beside the Excel sheets of the annual datasets is an extra sheet for the live links. It's always a good idea to separate live links from your company data. The live link Excel sheet has to include all values that you want to display in eSankey. The indirect function is only needed in those cells that refer to the measured values in a black font. Remember that the values in an orange font are just derived from the others. The indirect function itself should look like this. Inside the brackets, you first got to type in the cell that holds the name of the currently referred Excel sheet. In this case, it's the cell C1 that I renamed as Ref Year to make it more meaningful. The cell called Ref Year has the current value 2017, so we are referring to the Excel sheet called 2017. Next, we have to insert the concerned cell of the referred sheet, which is B4. Finally, you insert a boolean with the characteristic true right after a semicolon. I will write all indirect functions just like this. Now let's make a quick test whether the values are updated as we change the reference tag from 2017 to 2018. You can see that all cells of the Excel sheet called Live Links are now currently referring to the Excel sheet called 2018. This is where eSankey comes in again. The Live Links are referring to the cells of the sheet called Live Links. This one, on the other hand, is now able to refer to any other sheet inside Excel. Now that the live links are indirectly referring to the Excel sheet called 2018, guess what will happen as soon as I'm updating the live links inside eSankey? It's so easy. I just changed the sheet reference inside Excel to transitively update my Sankey diagram with the whole new dataset. The diagram just became a representation of the energy use in 2018. To ensure myself that eSankey shows the requested data, I've linked the title label to an Excel cell that holds the name of the diagram. The indirect function helps a lot in case that my Excel sheets are structured in the same way. In case that they are not, you still got the option to work with key value relations like the H lookup or V lookup. Working with the Sankey in this way won't only save a lot of time in the long term. It will also guarantee a constant diagram layout and design that comes in very handy if periodical diagrams are supposed to build on one another. Take advantage of the live links for recurring reports or comparing presentations. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. Thanks for watching.